Hey Grace Kids, it's so good to see you today. We've asked a lot of questions this month about Jesus and God. And so today the bottom line is Jesus is the answer. Jesus is always the answer. We hope you enjoy today.
Hey Grace Kids, welcome to Grace Kids Bible Trivia with Fink Winkleman. All month long, we've been asking questions that, well, questions kids would ask about God. We've learned a lot about the Bible this month, and so today, we're going to be playing a game show, and we have a couple of contestants who have come all the way from, I don't know where, who would like to play this game. Studio audience, which means you out there watching this video right now, let's hear it. Loud cheer for Poppy and the Little Mermaid! Hi. How are you?
I'm excited.
Have you been looking for this moment for like all day?
Yeah, my whole life.
Forever or all day?
Yes. Forever. For my whole life.
Your whole life?
Yeah. And I have glitter and everything in my back pocket if we need that.
Oh, good.
We will not need that.
Literally.
Okay, so I have some questions pre-recorded. They're written right here on my phone. And we have been, I hope you've been paying attention all month long.
I have.
Because these questions are pretty difficult. So when I ask the question, if you know the answer, what should you do?
Scream really loud!
That would be incorrect.
I use my dingle hopper.
Your giggle hopper?
Dingle hopper.
Dingle hopper. How about hit that buzzer right there, Little Mermaid?
Oh, okay.
Poppy?
Oh my goodness, it's such a fun noise!
Okay, so here we go.
Okay.
Each question, if you get the answer correctly, you earn a bazillion points.
A bazillion
points.
A lot of points. That's, I'm gonna get a lot of points.
Are you ready?
Yeah.
Are you ready? Here we go.
So, ready.
So I believe it was in week number 3, we learned there was a man who was swallowed by a huge fish. What was?
Jesus! Jesus is the answer!
I'm sorry, that's incorrect. Plus, if you interrupt my question, you have to give the rest of the question and then the answer. So let me ask the whole question. In week 3, we learned there was a man who was swallowed by a whale. What was his name, Little Mermaid? Hit the buzzer.
Jonah.
You have earned a bazillion points.
Good job!
Okay, so 1 bazillion to 0.
Okay.
Here we go. This one's going to be a little harder, but hopefully you're paying attention.
Okay.
What is the longest book in the Bible?
Oh my goodness. I think it's...
Is it Poppy?
Is it Psalms?
It is Psalms!
Yay!
Congratulations. What is the score?
Bazillion!
That is correct. So right now it is a tie game. It's anybody's game. Here we go. Okay? All right. So it is 1 bazillion to 1 bazillion.
Yes, we're
tied! Are you ready? Here we go.
We're
now this next one comes from the New Testament.
Okay.
How many disciples did Jesus have?
How many disciples?
Little Mermaid?
5.
5? Well,
yes.
5, that's part of the answer.
Oh, is there more?
There's more.
Oh.
Poppy?
I think it's 12.
You are correct.
Yay!
You now have 2 bazillion points.
I have 2 bazillion?
2 bazillion. Are you ready? Here we go, the next question. Okay. Think big, look up to the sky. Look up.
Big.
What was the name of the giant that David killed?
The giant.
Poppy.
Was his name Lion?
No. He did kill a lion, but his name was not Lion. Let's go to Little Mermaid. What was the name of the giant that David killed? Yes, Mermaid.
Ursula.
I am sorry, that is also incorrect. His name, kids, everybody tell me real quick, what was his name? That is correct.
Oh,
his name was Goliath. Good job, good job.
That.
All right, so it is 2 bazillion to 1 bazillion. We only have a few questions left.
Okay.
Mermaid, you gotta catch up.
I know.
You've
gotta
catch up.
Okay.
All right, this one's a pretty easy one. What is the first book of the Bible? Little Mermaid.
I think I know this one. Genesis.
You are correct. It is 2 bazillion to 2 bazillion. Now,
good
we're gonna
job.
Ask one more question to break the tie.
Okay. I'm ready.
Are you ready?
I'm ready.
Listen closely. What is the 67th book of the Bible?
I know it! This
what
is
the
so
answer?
Easy!
What is it?
Hezekiah!
I am so sorry, that's incorrect. There's only 66 books of the Bible. So our winner for today, since you give the wrong answer, and there's not 67, only 16, to give the wrong answer, is none other than the Little Mermaid! Yes, you have won a free trip to your room with no children.
Oh, yay!
So this is Pink Wilkerman. Thank you so much for joining us on Grace Kids Bible Trivia. Hi, Grace Kids. This is Pastor Scott. Hey, all month long, we've been learning the verse Jeremiah 33:3. Last month, I talked to you as a verse. It was John 3:16, and I asked you to send me a video of you saying the verse really fast, and you guys did an amazing job. I actually said John 3:16 in under 5 seconds, and I think you guys can do this verse, Jeremiah 33:3, in 5 seconds or less as well. Here's what you're going to do. You're going to make a video, and you're going to email it to me. And my email address here at the church, so we all get it, is gracekids@gracecovenant.org. You're going to see that on the screen right here. gracekids@gracecovenant.org, and you're gonna say this. Are you ready? Call to me and I'll answer you and show you great and unsearchable things you do not already know, Jeremiah 33:3. Okay, now you're going, wow, that was really, really fast. So let me slow it down for you, okay? For some of you, you know, you don't talk as fast as I do, and that's totally fine. So if you wanna do a little bit slower version, it would be like this. Call to me and I will answer you, and I will tell you great and unsearchable things that you do not know, Jeremiah 33:3. I don't care if you memorize it fast. I don't care if you memorize it slow. We just want you to hide God's word in your heart. And that is a great verse to memorize, because if you call to God, what will he do? He will answer you. So send me the video. If you can do under 5 seconds, that's awesome. Even if it's 10 or 15, it's still good.
Pastor Kate.
Hi, Pastor Danielle. How are you?
I'm doing great. How about you?
I'm doing great. You know, it is the end of May, which means we just finished up our whole series and all of the questions that kids were asking.
Oh my goodness, it was such a good series too. Did you guys enjoy that?
I enjoyed it.
I did too. We asked the questions, where did God come from? That one was really, really good. Does God get mad at me?
Oh, that I liked that answer. That was a good one.
What is the Trinity?
Mm-hmm. That was tough, but I think I understand a little bit more.
I got to play with ropes. That you one did. Was that a was lot fun. Of fun. It was a lot of fun. And let's see, we asked another one too. Oh, what is the big deal about prayer?
Yeah,
that one was really good too.
That was a really good one too, yeah.
But you know, Pastor Kate, all of these questions, they make me realize that there's actually one really big answer.
Oh, really? You think so?
I do, to all of the questions. Do you know what that answer is?
Chicken salad.
No, that's gross.
No. Egg salad?
No. Oh. Do you guys know what the answer is? It's Jesus.
Ooh, that makes sense.
Because, yeah, Jesus is the answer. Because he's everything. He's just the answer for everything.
Yeah. Well, and the fact that Jesus is the answer, it's because he created everything, right?
He did, yeah.
Yeah, so I have, I think, the best type of example that I want to show you, okay?
Okay.
So I've got this egg.
Oh, nice.
Yeah, so I don't know if you remember, but a couple weeks ago, I totally and it was awesome.
I do remember that.
Okay, I want you to know that I promise to you that if I were to say egg you, that it'd be completely fine. That nothing would happen.
Uh-huh.
Because I prepared this egg so that it wouldn't bust with the yolk going everywhere. In other words, I cooked this egg.
Okay,
so
hold on a second. You wanna egg me?
Yeah.
With that egg?
Yes, this egg right here.
Uh-huh. And a couple weeks ago, you egged Pastor Trish and it went all over her hair.
Yep, it was a great time.
But you're asking me to trust you that that's not gonna happen this time.
Promise.
Okay, and I'm supposed to trust you because, why again?
Because I prepared the egg and I know what happened to it.
Okay, so you prepared the egg.
Yeah.
So I should trust you that I'm not gonna get messy.
Exactly.
All right, guys, should I trust her?
Okay, so.
Okay, all right, Pastor Kate. I will trust you that you can egg me.
Okay, all right, let me help you out a bit. Ready? All right, everybody count down with me. 3, 2, 1. See, nothing happened.
Hey,
way!
Because...
I'm not messy!
I hard-boiled the egg, it's so clean!
Wow!
So, I see this as an example of us trusting Jesus for all the answers, because he created the world. I prepared this egg, he created the world. We know that he's trustworthy, that he is good, that he is faithful. And so when we have hard questions, we can go to the Bible and trust the Bible for what it says because it's God's word.
You're absolutely right. And Jesus, he actually asked lots of questions.
He did.
And he wants us to ask questions.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. But sometimes Jesus asked his followers and his disciples questions back, like, do you believe in me? And this is a great example of that, because if I didn't believe and trust Pastor Kate, well, I wouldn't have seen the egg crack open, right? I would have missed out on that.
Yeah.
And missed out on going like, wow, that really connects back to Jesus being the answer.
Yeah, it's so great. And so kids, we want you to remember that the questions that you have, trust that Jesus has the answer and that we can look to him for guidance.
Absolutely. And you know what, guys? You can believe in Jesus right now because he's the one that has the answers to all of the questions.
Yeah.
He is preparing things in this season that we can't even see or imagine, but he wants you to believe in him.